Hi, my name's Ian Van Tile, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2013 Jeannot 409 Sun Odyssey. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this vessel has to offer. So we're here at Southwestern Yacht Club, and you can see Satori is a beautiful vessel that is kept in pristine condition. The Jeannot 409 Sun Odyssey is a Philippe Brion hull design. This particular hull design is a very powerful, fast, and stable vessel that is very easy to single hand. The vessel itself has a hard shine that starts at midship and carries its way all the way back to the transom, giving you a really stiff and stable ride offshore. You can see there's lots of overhead opening hatches. They're all flush, giving it a real modern, streamlined look. We also have the jib sheets up on the cabin top with the extra Genoa tracks on the side deck that allows you to put a larger Genoa if so desired. The vessel is also equipped with a really high-end dodger, connector, and bimini, along with all cockpit cushions, covers, and companionway cover that you'll see in the listing. But we're going to take you up to the fore deck, and as we step on board the vessel, you're going to see this really nice stainless steel grab handle that's located here. You're also going to notice a series of snaps. Now, this particular dodger is a convertible dodger, so the bimini connector can actually be removed, and then there are quick pins on the inside of this, which will undo. This top piece will come off. This aft bow will fold up forward, and it'll create just a windshield, letting lots of additional light into the vessel cockpit itself. Now, Jeannot is really known for a solid, stable performance cruiser, but this is a really nice addition that Jeannot's done, is they've kept the Traveler on the Sun Odyssey series, and this will give you that extra stability that you need when underway with trimming the sails and to making it a little bit more upright if you're in breezier conditions. So a really nice, a great addition here. It also has what's called the German sheeting. So that's double-ended main sheets. So the main sheet itself gets led back to both helms, again, making it very easy to single and shorthand sail. Lots of, again, opening hatches on the top, Genoa tracks here on the cabin top, so you can see just how tight those sheeting angles can go. This vessel sails very, very well upwind. Inboard shrouds. Now, this is a really nice upgrade here that they've done on the Sun Odyssey. It gives you a really nice, easy access up to the foredeck itself. Now, as we make our way up to the foredeck, we have lots of real estate up here, great area for lounging. We also have additional pad eyes. There are three really nice high-end stainless steel cleats found on each side of the vessel. And then as we move up forward, you're gonna see the double bow roller system along with the tack attachment point contact. So that is a really nice tack attachment point. And this particular vessel set up with a code zero. So again, really making this a nice, well-rounded sail plan. Looking back aft, you're gonna see that we have the Sparcraft mast. It is in-mast furling with two spreaders. We also have the radar TV antenna mounted up top, along with deck light and steaming light. The deck light is LED, and all navigation lights are LED standard. As we move back, you can see just how nice and clean all of the sheets and halyards lead into the cockpit itself. So when you're underway, there is no need to come up forward. You also have a wood built-in grab rail here. This is a nice orientation of that. And again, really nice stainless steel grab handles on the Dodger itself. As we move into the cockpit, you're gonna see just how nice and large this cockpit is. It has really deep backrest, and that's something that you really wanna point out when you're going on long voyages. It's just a comfortable cockpit to be in. As you can see with the hard shines and the way that Philippe Brion has designed this vessel, it is a real beanie vessel with a drop down platform. And I wanted to show you how easy it was to lower down the rear transom. There is a lock latch here that keeps it into place. There's also this small spin lock Harkin. What you do is you just kind of initially kind of get it going. Once you have it going, then it really is a matter of a really lightweight fingertip hold on this, lowering it down nice and softly into place. The line itself goes through that cutout, and then you close a hatch.
And now you have full access to the drop-down swim platform. There is a dedicated life raft locker, and this is where your companionway hatch stows, so there's no need to take it down below. As you can see here, the companionway hatch slides right out of place, and it has a great area to stow right here in the designated life raft locker. Now this lifts up into place, and as you can see, there's a small little starboard separator panel that slides conveniently there, closes off, and now that is where your companionway stows, so you don't have to be taking it down below and having a potential of marking up any of your wood. We have hot and cold swim step showers here, propane lockers associated on this side, and then off to the starboard side, we have our engine controls. So the engine controls are quite nice. We have good visual down to our RPM gauge, upgraded composite wheels, nice stainless steel grab handle just forward of the wheels with our Plasimo compass, our multi-repeater, and our autopilot controls. Again, both jib sheet and main sheet are led back to each helm, so once your mainsail is unfurled, the whole operation of the vessel is done from right here at the helm. Centrally located is our SIMRAD plotter. This is a GPS plotter with radar integration. This is in a nice pivoting pod, as you can see. The pod itself can twist to different angles. We also have a great upgraded cockpit table with the wood leafs on both sides. There is a forward glove box, there is an aft glove box, and centrally located is a great area for stowage with built-in stainless steel handrails and footrails as well down below. At the port helm, we have a multi-repeater that will show us our depth, speed, and wind, and again, gives you great visual to what you're looking for here with instrumentation, with a plotter that will pivot again to either helm. A really nice upgrade that was done on this yacht is the owner has done solid lifelines from the forward gate entry all the way around to the transom. Here, what he's also done is created a brace. So you can actually house a 15 horse outboard, and then you have your solid stainless engine lift on the port side. Now off to the starboard side, what he's done is he's done the same thing. He's integrated it here and wrapped that all the way around, giving you nice attachment points for your bimini, so there's nothing going into the deck itself. And again, gives you that peace of mind and security when stepping outside the cockpit. The cockpit cushions are set up quite nice, so they're nice and clean looking. We have two very large lazarette lockers, and when I go down below, I'm going to show you what really makes this layout quite unique. Here at the cabin top, again, all the sheets and halyards are led aft, and so it makes it very easy to operate. We have our outhaul and our furling line that's led up here, along with our spinnaker, halyard, vang adjustment, traveler adjustments. But again, the attention to detail with this Dodger, with built-in handles here, again, the quick pin systems, the nano tracking at the bottom of it, so there's no twist shackles or snaps to kind of keep that in place. This is really set up quite nicely. And then it actually has the Macrolon glass window here, so really high-end canvas package. Now, as we come down below the vessel, you're gonna see we have four nice, easy, gradual steps. The galley is off to the starboard side. The galley itself possesses a nice two-burner stove and oven. We have the custom microwave, LG microwave, that was installed here. Top-loading refrigerator with a small freezer compartment. Double stainless steel sinks. Really nice Corian countertops and nice, you know, fixtures throughout. There is a backsplash on this as well, too. Just below the double stainless steel sink is our built-in trash can, additional stowage. We also have lots of subsole storage on this boat. So again, so what you don't see right here, there's tons of subsole storage throughout. Now, just behind the galley is our aft cabin. Now, the aft cabin's set up quite nicely. This is a full queen berth back here. A very, very nice berth. There is a hull port on this side with aviation style shades, 110 12 volt outlet, a nice reading lamp, a full hanging locker, and shelving. You also have your cabin top port, overhead opening hatch, LED lighting throughout, and then another opening hatch here that leads into the cockpit. But as you can see, the 409 possesses a beautiful salon here. It's very large for the size of a vessel, and it is set up quite nicely. Now, the companionway steps, again, a nice gradual angle, and in a matter of seconds, this lifts up with gas-assisted shocks that keep it up. But we have our Yanmar engine here. Now, what this owner's done is he's actually moved the Raycor filter up forward. So you have easy access to your Raycor filter, your primary filter, your water pump impeller. So again, great access to all of that in our sea strainers back there. You have access from both sides, front and behind as well. Directly across from the galley is our nav station, but just after that is our day head and shower. We have a really high-end stainless steel sink, lots of cabinetry, lighting, overhead opening hatches. There are two of them in this head compartment. A separate shower, which is nice because this plexiglass door will enclose this shower compartment off and really making this a dry area. Just aft through this door is the garage. Now, I call it the garage because this is where you're stowing your code zero, you know, cockpit cushions. There's the filler cushion for the salon table when it drops down. You have areas for tools and compartments, and again, a great use of space. This is the manual JAPSCO toilet, and there's the switch for the sump pump while you're having the shower. As we move up forward, the starboard side of the salon is, again, very, very large. The table leaf itself can actually fold over on itself, making this area a lot larger when not in use. And then the whole leaf itself from the table is on a rail system that slides down. The filler cushion will go in, and now you have a great lounging area to sit and enjoy watching television and what have you. Large bench seat off to the port side and a forward-facing nav station. We also have an upgraded Magma inverter charger, a Fusion stereo, a Simrad docking hub station that's integrated with the Fusion itself, and you have full controls in the cockpit as well too from the Simrad GPS plotter. 110, 12 volt. We have our tank indication gauges here, so it allows us to monitor our fuel, our battery capacities, and our water capacities from here. ICOM VHF, and then what we have in the nav station is our winches, our VHF ram mic that mounts in the cockpit, and then forward of this is our Blu-ray Samsung DVD player that's integrated into the Samsung flat screen television that's up on the bulkhead. Again, it's all one level throughout, you know, this vessel. So it's an easy boat to walk on, has the teak and holly floors. This is the upgraded ultra leather. So you can see it has a really nice texture. But what I love about it is it's very forgiving. So if you spill red wine on it, it wipes right up. Now we're moving into the forward V-berth and second head compartment off to the starboard side. But as you can see, the V-berth is really nice here. They have two ports on the hull with aviation style shades. And what I love about the design of this window has they kind of arced it down is you can actually look up forward and have great visual while being right here in the forward stateroom. So if you're kind of a worrywart in the evenings about your anchor and what have you, this is a great window design. Lots of cabinetry, stowage, hanging lockers, and again, directly across from here is our second head and shower compartment. So this is quite nice. This is a manual JAPSCO toilet. We have our stainless steel sink, faucet, mirror, and again, really set up nicely. The faucet comes out, and then this is what actuates as the shower, and then you have your sump pump down below. This will give you another perspective of the salon looking aft. Well, I hope you found this video walkthrough to be helpful and informative. If you like more information in regards to this 2013 Jeannot 409 Sun Odyssey, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tile, at any time, day or night. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.